Thank you and good morning. Canva was founded over 10 years ago with the mission to empower the world to design. We've built a product that makes it easy for anyone, regardless of their skill level, to create stunning visual content at scale. Today, Canva is used by more than 220 million users in 190 countries to create and collaborate on everything from presentations to videos to whiteboards and more. But we're all engineers here, so please allow me some vanity metrics. Our platform handles about 1.2 million requests per second. We have over 162 petabytes of media under management, and that's growing by about 230 terabytes every day. To date, we've had over 30 billion designs created, and our users are adding over 450 new designs every second. But I want to take you all the way back to the very beginning of this journey, when most of these numbers were very close to zero. I joined Canva back in 2014, when there were just a handful of us. Here you can see most of the back-end engineering team back then, and around this time, we're in a single room, it's cheap rent, and there's a dodgy fuse box. And in winter, we could choose. Do we run heaters, or do we have external monitors? And naturally, we chose monitors, and we adapted. And I took this photo around this time of me literally coding in fingerless gloves because it was so freezing. Now, top of our minds around this time was the architectural quandary. How do we build something quickly and get it into market, but build it in a way that allows us to rapidly evolve our architecture to scale? We knew we would eventually need some kind of microservices architecture. This would ultimately allow us to scale the number of components that we had independently, and it would allow us to scale in the number of engineers productively working on our platform. And so we planned for this microservices future, and we built and shipped a monolith. But baked into this monolith's design was a pathway to scale. It was completely stateless, which allowed us to scale horizontally using elastic load balancing and auto-scaling, and it was carefully modeled around the key entities we had identified. And we implemented this model with some simple rules to make it decomposable in the future. Each entity was encapsulated by a service interface, and our service interfaces strived for consistency around a really simple set of CRUD verbs. All the business orchestration has to happen above this service abstraction. These rules allowed us to tease apart this monolith relatively easily when the need for scale came. Our service interfaces became RPC stubs, and one execution unit involved to one per service. Now, our initial architecture was backed by a single RDS MySQL database. But in designing our schema, we similarly tried to anticipate scale. We maintained strict isolation of entity relations. If you needed to perform some business orchestration that involved more than one entity, you must compose that using the CRUD operations on the services. As tempting as it was, cross-domain joining at the persistence layer was strictly forbidden. This meant that our one MySQL instance was easily decomposed into multiple MySQL instances as the need for scale came. And each MySQL instance, we could add more scale. We can scale out through read replicas, and we can scale up through instance sizing. And then finally, as our exponential growth exploded, many of our services migrated over to DynamoDB, which continues to give us global scale. Now, I would love to tell you that this process of evolving our persistence was always smooth. It was not. The thing about exponential growth is that it can be hard for humans, even engineers, to grasp. And we felt this acutely in our media service. The exploding popularity of Canva meant that our media service MySQL suddenly got like really, really big on us. We knew we had to get over to DynamoDB, and to buy time to engineer a seamless transition, we raced to put an abstraction layer over our persistence, and at the same time, we milked every last bit of life out of MySQL, which by that stage was groaning under the weight of tables hundreds of millions of rows in size and growing by tens of millions of rows every day and hitting new and exciting RDS limits on a regular basis. And the joy of building Canva in Sydney, Australia, is that the US traffic peak is just after 1 a.m. Sydney time. So we'd often discover these limits in the haze of a middle of the night on-call alert. Now, stretching the capacity of MySQL involved lots of database dark arts. We first removed all foreign keys because they prevent zero downtime schema migrations. Then we started denormalizing a bunch of the schema because at that size, even joins become prohibitively expensive. And finally, we started consolidating data into JSON blobs in text columns so that we could lift the schema management up into the application layer. By the time we were ready to switch over to DynamoDB, we had morphed MySQL into a dodgy KV store, and the middle of the night wake-up calls were getting pretty boring. But get there we did, and today our DynamoDB-backed media service manages 93 billion items, and it's growing at around 90 million items per day. And we get really impressive performance and reliability. Fundamental to evolving for scale at Canva is investing carefully in the abstractions we provide within our architecture. We strive to make them powerful, consistent, and composable. We've now carried that focus and care forward in developing a powerful API that lets anyone build functionality on top of Canva. We offer the Apps SDK, which lets you build embedded functionality in Canva, and the Connect API, which lets you embed Canva functionality in your platforms. Today, thousands of developers in more than 120 countries are building on Canva and contributing to a thriving marketplace of over 300 apps and counting. And these apps have been used over a billion times by our users. On the screen is one of my favorites, the Crikey 3D animation app. During its first month on Canva, Crikey saw a 10% conversion rate among Canva users who tried it. Thank you for letting me share a little snippet of Canva's engineering journey. Our founder, Mel, wants to put Canva in the hands of all 8.2 billion people on the planet. She loves to say, we're only 1% of the way there. Now, I don't want to quibble with Mel, but at 220 million monthly actives, my math tells me we're actually closer to 2.72% of the way there. I can't wait to see what the next 10 years and beyond will bring, and I really hope that you will join us on that journey. Thank you.